Okay, question. What is your favorite day of the week?
Saturday or Sunday.
Is that because it's like the quintessential day off kind of thing?
Yeah, like I never really wanted to work weekends, so I just never did.
My whole life has been working weekends.
Well, until when the business took off, I started working weekends.
Oh, okay. But you like Saturday and Sunday off?
Yeah, dude.
I hate it.
Why?
People.
What do you mean?
Because I have historically Tuesday and Wednesday off, and then I enjoy life. I get to go to like Target, and there's no soccer moms there. I get to go to Starbucks, and there's no soccer moms there. They're all at work.
You sound like you hate soccer moms.
I just don't like people.
But you don't. I don't go to kids' soccer games on Saturday and Sunday, oddly so I don't enough, see them either.
If their name is Karen, I'm probably not going to like them very much.
Really?
Probably.
I know the sweetest Karen.
Really?
No.
I fucking do it. My favorite day of the week is probably Wednesday. Again, because there's just less people out. Everyone's either at school or at work. And
it's because it's hump day, huh?
Hump day? That's also true. It's my also second favorite day out.
What's today, June 11th?
I don't know.
Uh-oh.
I don't keep track.
Well, if you haven't lost weight yet, you're going to be foul summer!
The Social Nuisance Podcast.
Oh, shit! Okay, bitches, you guys are going to be mind blown.
Oh, we're going to Pound Town.
Social Nuisance Podcast. How you guys doing? My name is Imagine.
He's a badass motherfucker.
Social Nuisance!
Oh, yeah. What the fuck is up?
Yeah, Social Nuisance Podcast. What the fuck is up, motherfuckers?
Yeah. Hold up. Cut real quick.
I really want to know where there's like...
earphone shit all over your neck and your shirt. Sorry.
I don't care. Oh, I mean, normally...
What's fucking driving me crazy?
Normally, I would care if it was, like, at home and we're just not fucking caring about anything. But, unfortunately, we're in front of a camera and shit, so...
How weird is
that? I guess I should care about these things.
What was driving me berserk? That's all I could look at.
I'm not gonna cut.
You look like my grandma's couch.
Don't edit it. Whatever. Are you gonna put me, like, in that clear plastic shit?
Maybe.
Where you, like, if you sat down and got up, you could never do it quietly because you had, like, the...
It would stick to your skin?
Yeah, especially when it's hot like fucking today.
It's for when the visitors come out?
Yeah. Hello and welcome to the Social Nuisance Podcast, our weekly discussion of all things current, requiring further insight, opinions, questions, and otherwise kick-in-your-face perspectives towards the betterment of humanity. Subscribe and leave us a 5-star review on iTunes or wherever you're listening to the show to help us grow and get in on the discussions by liking our Facebook page and following us on Instagram. We're brought to you today... in regard to visuals by Productive Culture, if you're looking to start your own podcast in the SoCal area and need that fine polishing, hit them up. They provide full service recording, mixing, mastering, and podcast production. Let them know Social Nuisance sent you, and your first episode is free.
Hmm?
Yeah, dude.
What?
Fucking free.
Are we giving free episodes?
No, we're not. Productive Culture is. Productive Culture. That's how they stay productive. They do free episodes.
Yeah?
Well, because they're fucking dope at it, so... Let them know, hey, we're fucking kick ass, and then, of course, you're gonna give us money afterwards. I mean, we did. Facts.
Did we?
Productiveculture.com/podcast.
This show already gone off the rails?
Yep.
All right.
My name's Imagine, and join me as always, a man who wants to be the De Niro of podcasts, but ended up here.
The De Niro?
Hello, Motion.
Yes, sir.
The De Niro, not Pacino.
Like, I'm gonna put these on.
Oh.
Future's so bright.
Oh. I always stay bright.
Future's so bright.
Super bright. Why you wanted to be the De Niro?
Do
not
what?
Not Pacino?
Did I say that?
Isn't that... You said you wanted to be the De Niro.
The De Niro of podcasts?
The De Niro of podcasts.
When did I say... I said that?
I don't know.
You gotta stop talking to me when I'm on stuff.
So we've been gone for like a week and a half or so, and that's mainly because you were out of the... I was gonna say out of the country, but technically, according to Donald Trump, it is.
Yeah, no, it's country.
You're in Puerto Rico.
Yeah.
Dude, how the fuck was Puerto Rico?
It's fucking beautiful, dude. The only way I could describe the feeling is like, you know when your cell phone's low?
Yeah.
And it's like at the red?
Yeah.
I felt like that was my life.
Oh.
And then I plugged in, and I just sat and chilled to recharge my battery at Earth, dude.
So you live dangerously just living on red.
Oh, always, dude.
And then you went to Puerto Rico, and now you're back to green.
Yeah. I feel so much better about like.
I hate you, because I was watching the social media posts and whatnot. And
yeah, they got a lot of hate.
Because we weren't there.
Yeah.
I just was
pissed off. Well, fuck you. No, 20 minutes into coming. Oh, so first of all, our flight got canceled on the way home. And it was United, so they couldn't fucking care less.
True.
Right?
Yeah.
Worst whatever they are
Airlines.
Ever. Yeah.
Yeah.
So then when we finally get back to Los Angeles, 20 minutes in the lift, dead traffic. I was like, oh, yeah. I'm fucking done. Let's go.
Oh, Los Angeles?
I'm done. Yep.
You're back in LA? Like,
I'm out. I'm out. I'm over it.
I just got back, and I'm already back down to red.
I just want to go home. I just want to go back home to Puerto Rico.
So have you found like a specific region that you found the most favorable?
Yeah, like, well, to live, I would want to stay like near or outside San Juan because that would be the best for the kids.
Okay.
Makes and sense. Then like biggest, newest, nicest hospital, excuse me, is about 20 minutes from there. Nice. So that would be good for, you know, wifey to work at.
Facts.
And then I would just, I think about retiring at like 34, 34 and a half.
That's a solid strategy.
You know what I mean?
I'm going to follow up on that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm 34 now. Oh, my birthday passed.
Oh.
I forgot that I'm 34. So maybe 34 and a half.
Okay. Maybe in a couple months. Got to get, you know, logistics.
Yeah. Figuring it out.
That's pretty dope.
Got to get the right pillow. But no, it was awesome, dude.
Like the right hammock. I'm going
to. Oh, you want to hear a funny hammock story?
Oh, yeah.
I got a hilarious fucking hammock story. All right.
Okay.
I'm it ready. All starts about a month ago on Groupon. Okay.
All good stories begin at bars and Groupon.
Groupon's pretty much a bar. So, $10 hammock.
Okay.
Fucking buy it.
Yeah.
We get it. Like 4 weeks before our trip.
Okay.
So I'm like, all right, cool. The night before the trip, we're leaving at 2 a.m. to be ready to fly at 5 a.m. LAX.
Nice.
Can't find the fucking hammock. Tore the house apart.
How do you lose a hammock?
Where do you put a hammock? I don't have a fucking hammock cabinet. Like a hammock drawer where you keep all your hammocks?
That's the goal, though, like to have a big enough house.
Where I kept telling myself, like, where the fuck would I put a hammock? If I had to put a hammock away, where would I put it?
Was it just left it in the car?
No. I don't know if I forgot where I found it. Irrelevant. Anyways, we get to Puerto Rico. Not once do we use a fucking hammock.
Is that because they already had them there?
Not because the trees are too far apart.
That's the other thing. I can envision, like, walking around on the beach with a hammock in hand, just kind of dragging in the sand. Just looking for the perfect set of trees.
Well, it bundled up into a cute little package.
Yeah.
But,
Oh.
Yeah, we never used it. But,
So you feel like you failed in life because you didn't use your hammock? You didn't Puerto Rico right.
That's fucked up, dude. You just ruined the trip. We got to go back now.
As long as I get to go with. I was going to go with.
I told you to come with.
You know, baby and whatever.
Fucking kids, dude. I'm telling you. You over it yet? Put it back, bro.
Yeah, I gotta send it back.
Put it back.
Yeah, it's not done cooking. I'm gonna put it back in. Shit, there's another thing we gotta get into, so I'm just gonna jump right into it. While you were gone, the country continued to fall apart.
Really?
Yeah.
That just makes my trip better.
Yeah, there was a guy named Steve Johnson in the Bay Area who cemented a giant swastika, and it's right in his front yard, and his neighbors are not happy with it.
In San Francisco?
Yeah, in the Bay Area. So this guy named Steve Johnson, he defended his actions by saying it's a Tibetan symbol, and it's his damn yard to do what he did well pleases.
That is kind of true.
King Dice, we posted this on Facebook, and he wrote, yeah, they have all the places in the world to look, so look away, in regards to his neighbors. It's like, it's true. If it's your fucking yard, if you want to put a fucking swastika in the middle of it, go right ahead. And your neighbors just suck it. Pretty much, right?
I mean, I guess.
I mean, here's the thing. I don't like what he's doing and what he's expressing. He's expressing his hatred and whatnot. And first and foremost, let me just be clear that this guy, definitely it's his yard. He could do whatever the fuck he wants to do with his yard. But it's important to note that he's a pussy.
Yeah, well,
he's
exactly.
A total pussy because saying it's a Tibetan symbol.
That's what I was going
to
get at.
Yeah, and he's not owning up to the fact that he's having a Nazi love affair. And if you're going to be proud enough to put it out there, own that shit.
Yeah.
So he's a fucking pussy. But by all means, it's your house. Do whatever the fuck you want with it. And it just sucks for your neighbors, unfortunately. And in that regard, what I would do is like put a bunch of like Hitler hanging from a noose and I don't know.
I don't think that works.
Fuck Nazis. Wait for him to come out of his house and go punch him in the face. Fuck Nazis.
Find fucked up ways to keep torturing him. Find out what he's afraid of and keep putting it in his mailbox. Jewish, you know, shit like that.
Jewish mail?
What's Jewish mail? Money?
Well, I remember living in a house where the previous owners of the house signed up to one of those religious organizations where they continue asking to like send money for the poor children of Israel. I was like, according to the news, they're doing okay.
Israel?
Yeah. I've never been, so I don't know. But point being, you know.
I think you should be able to do whatever the fuck you want your house. But, like, also there are rules and regulations as to, like, colors you could paint your house, shapes your house could be, like, yeah. Shit like that. So
his homeowners association is going to be pissed.
Yeah, exactly. And then technically, I believe you don't own your driveway.
You don't own your driveway?
I believe not. I believe the driveway is property of the state.
So if I wanted to color my driveway, I'd have to get that cleared?
I believe. Well, yeah, you would probably have to get it permitted regardless, right?
What, to own one?
No, to like make changes.
You buy the house and you buy the driveway separately?
No, I don't think so. I think you have to get, well, you would have to get a permit to make a change like that. But I know there's certain like private roads and shit have to be established. I don't know, dude.
That's fucking bullshit.
Stuff like that.
So technically you're on the side of it's his house, do whatever the fuck you want with it.
Kind of. But I understand the position that why it bothers them. It would bother me.
It definitely bothers me.
It's probably going to fuck up values, right?
Definitely going to fuck up values.
But also,
unless they go like a far right neighborhood, then at that point it's like, you're welcomed here.
He set himself up for torture, though.
Yeah, I definitely think so. Louis, was it Floaty? I think he's one of your friends.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Louis Floaty?
I never asked him.
Okay, Floaty, because it sounds it sounds better.
The homie Louis.
He said, yeah, it's his place, but with someone else, it's a target, and it's going to bring problems to the area. So
it will.
To your point, he's definitely going to have some fucking issues. So, Steve Johnson, it's your neighborhood. Do whatever the fuck you want to do at your house, but you're a pussy. Also on that note, other pussies that are going to cause trouble. Oh, we're going to talk about pussy. Super Happy Fun America. Have you heard of this organization?
No, what is this?
Super Happy Fun America?
Sounds great.
Oh, they sound like a good time, but they're also a bunch of fucking assholes. They're going to be, they're behind the upcoming Straight Pride Parade in Boston.
What's wrong with that?
You haven't heard of this parade that's going to happen in Boston?
Yeah, I kind of have.
Oh, man. So no date has been set, but they're shooting for August. So, of course, we're celebrating Pride Month. And the pride is definitely towards, you know, the LGBTQ plus community. I think I got that right. And cool. Good for them. Man. You got to have their own month.
You know what's funny to me? What, like, really, of all things gay, what's gayer than a parade? You ever heard a straight guy like, hey, get your shorts on, man. We got to run down to the parade.
Get your flag. We got to go.
A straight parade? Yeah. That sounds gay as fuck.
Straight pride parade. No date has been set, but it's going to be going down in Boston, hopefully in August.
Good luck, man.
Yeah, good for them.
Good for them.
This is just like All Lives Matter to me.
All Lives Matter?
All Lives Matter. So you have an organization that has gotten some attention to their cause, in this case, a celebration of who they are, regardless of persecution and harassment and so on and so forth. So they're taking pride in who they are. And by all means, you certainly should. But then there's always, you know, that upset kid at the party feeling left out, and they feel the need to say, I'm special too. And then they blurt out some stupid shit like All Lives Matter. It's kind of the same shit.
It's the same approach, but the fact that there's no date set makes it not even real. Like,
well, apparently they have like the permits, they got it clear, but they just haven't had a date set.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool. I mean, more power. They did in the right spot.
In Boston?
Yeah, that'd be the safest spot for a straight parade. Do it anywhere else, a bunch of gay guys are going to show up and wreck the party.
They're probably going to do that anyways.
I just don't understand why a parade.
Well, because they're trying to bite off the fact that, you know, the pride parade. Well, okay, cool. We can have a gay pride parade. Well, we're going to have a straight pride parade. That'll show them.
But why are you trying to bite off?
Get the fuck out of here.
The, like, trademark of what you're trying to be the opposite of.
So what would be the antithesis of a pride parade?
A straight flag football game.
A gathering inside Steve's man cave in Boston?
I don't know, man.
That also sounds pretty gay. I'm just saying, I mean.
Have you ever been to a pride parade?
I've been to pride celebrations.
Yeah?
Yeah, not an exclusive parade. I hear they're.
Have you seen
flamboyant.
Any of the posts on social media?
Sounds like a good time. Don't get me fucking wrong. I mean,
the Pride Parade or the Straight Parade?
Both. I've been to WeHo for Halloween. Same shit, almost.
Yeah.
Really is. Have you been to WeHo for Halloween?
Yeah.
It is some shit.
Yeah. I do it for a self-esteem booster.
I had a random girl grab my dick.
A girl?
A random girl just grabbed my dick.
I don't think girls grab dicks in WeHo, bro.
No, she did.
No. Maybe she was a girl for Halloween?
I was not yet drinking. Mm. I was dressed as Charlie Brown. I was walking down the street with my then girlfriend at the time. And this random girl was like, oh, shit, Charlie Brown. And then she just grabbed my dick. And then kept walking.
You didn't file charges?
I was blown away. I've never had a woman wanted to grab my dick in such a manner and just continue walking away. My girlfriend at the time, yeah, cool.
Did you pay it forward?
Did I pay it forward?
Yeah, did you go grab another random dick?
No.
No?
I was blown away. I was shocked. I say. What the hell do you do? I mean, I was like, wow, that was pretty dope. Like, random girl grabbed my dick. That was cool. But then I was like, I feel kind of violated.
I was going to say, that only goes that way, right?
Bullshit, yeah.
You can't run up and just grab snatch, right?
Yeah.
Unless you're Donald Trump.
Donald Trump.
Good for him, dude.
Very, very presidential out here.
Good for him.
So that's pretty dope. So shout out Super Happy Fun America.
Super Happy Fun America.
Super Happy Fun America.
It's a joke, dude. The whole thing has to be a joke, man.
Yeah.
Ever since the, like...
Do you think they're going to go through with it?
No, not at all.
No?
Because straight people don't parade unless they're at Disneyland with their kids.
That's true. Well, then all the performers in said Disney parade are probably gay anyways.
I feel like that was a broad generalization.
Well, I would say a good,
I'm just kidding.
A good majority of them. Absolutely. I've been there. I've seen it. It's a good example of appropriation of just people trying to bite off something that's not theirs. Just again, we'll show them.
But then in that way, you're acting just like them.
That's some stupid shit.
It is dumb as fuck.
Speaking of appropriation, Wrangler. Have you heard that Lil Nas song? Lil Nas?
The cowboy song?
The Old Town. Fuck, someone in this room help me out here. Old Town Road?
Yeah, I have.
I've not heard it.
Yeah, you've heard it. Trust me, you've heard it.
I have?
You've heard it.
I listen to the radio.
I don't either.
So how did you hear it? You have kids that are of age.
That's true. And I actually...
Kid Vicious listened to it, I'm sure.
No, I don't think he does.
No?
I asked Desi yesterday if he knew the song and he started singing it. But I saw it somewhere. I don't know where the fuck I saw or heard it. But trust me, you've heard it.
Okay.
It's everywhere.
I've not willingly have turned it on like, hey, I want to listen to this
song. Absolutely.
Anyways...
It's not a bad song, man.
Really?
It's not a bad song.
I'm not a fan of any rapper with the name Little in front of their name. Except Lil Dicky. He's pretty dope. Or country music. So I find it very hard to believe that I'm going to enjoy this song.
You know what's fucked up? Is country music rejected it. It wouldn't put it on their top 10.
Yeah.
And then when he made the video, he went and got Hannah Fontana's dad.
Well, he was already on the song. Billy Ray Cyrus.
No, he did the second version with him. And now it's like the number one country song.
Really?
Yeah, blatant racism.
He wasn't on the original thing?
I don't think so. It's a story I heard, dude. But
fuck
I could have dreamt it. Could have made it up.
Wrangler, the Jeez company... they partnered with Lil Nas due to
that's gonna be terrible for his street credit.
Old Town Road, and now the cowboys who willingly sport Wrangler jeans are crying foul.
Why?
Saying it's cultural appropriation.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, isn't it?
No.
It's not.
I would say that Lil Nas, again, assuming he wanted to cross over with genres musically, and he. Fucking explored it successfully, apparently.
Remember when all the skaters flipped out because Lupe Fiasco did Kick Push?
That was like an anthem, though. They didn't freak out.
Nah, skaters didn't like it.
Really?
Yeah.
I loved it.
I loved it, too.
But again, I didn't really skateboard too much, but, you know.
I did, but I was a Fiasco fan.
Gotcha.
But it's like one of those things, unless you were raised in that culture,
yeah,
it's not even about you making the song. It's about you making success off the culture.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But
I find a cultural appropriation, like the whole like Native American headdresses at Coachella. That's some bullshit, not knowing what the fuck you're wearing and what it's supposed to be worn for and just like, oh, it looks cute.
Remember in the Jungle Book when Baloo dressed up like the monkeys to dance with them?
I think that was a disguise.
Yeah, that's cultural appropriation.
Not if it's a disguise.
No, because then he sang and danced with them?
I didn't say it was good disguise.
They didn't trick him. He didn't trick nobody.
I think if you have a bad disguise, that's just racist.
Is it? Like Kanye blackface?
You're like, I think... I'm going to put some lackluster effort into my disguise, and that lackluster effort is based on a stereotype. That's probably just racist.
But bottom line, like, if anybody should embrace cultural appropriation, it's fucking cowboys, right? I mean, they're getting far and few between. No one wants to be a cowboy anymore.
No, not even Dallas Cowboy fans wants to be cowboys anymore.
Cowboys don't want to be cowboys.
Not really. So I thought it was very ironic that, you know, historically speaking, cultural appropriation is taking from, you know, minorities, whether it be the Asian culture, Latin American culture, Native American culture, so on and so forth. And now all of a sudden you have the cowboys, who are usually the ones offending in this situation. They're now on the flip side. They're like, wait a minute.
Well, I don't think the cowboys usually appropriate
You're
culture.
You're not a real cowboy. You can't wear Wranglers.
But the funny thing is how many times have you played cowboys and Indians and been a shitty ass cowboy?
I never played cowboy. I went to a cowboy and Indians party. It was not my greatest choice in life. I went to a cowboy and Indian party, and I went dressed like an Indian from India.
Oh, you?
Yeah.
Smart ass.
They didn't specify, and they're like, technically, you're trying to portray cowboys and Native Americans, but you said Indians, and technically, I'm the only one that's historically accurate in this room.
How many people rolled their eyes when you walked in?
Pretty much everybody.
All
told
of
me
them?
To get the fuck out. Because I was a buzzkill, because, you know, I brought historical context. And
But did you, so you cultural appropriated?
No, I was just geographically accurate.
Was it a lackluster effort? Was it racist?
It was pretty racist.
Oh, you fuck.
It was pretty racist.
I knew it. I just didn't think you'd say it.
No, it was pretty racist. I apologize.
Do you ever wonder?
About what?
I don't know. Just, that was it.
I wonder about all kinds of shit. I wonder about being sober curious.
About what?
Being sober. You haven't heard about this?
No, what?
Being sober curious?
No, what?
Okay, so there's this new trend. It's the latest thing, like veganism, but not. Sober curious is the latest trend of where bars have no alcohol. So you go to a bar and you drink with friends, but all said drinks have no alcohol in them. All
right.
That's pretty dope, right?
Are the drinks stupid expensive?
No, they're actually a little bit less, but they still come in like, you know, a copper cup or some stupid shit. So
raise
it up a dollar.
That sounds like cultural appropriation of bars.
Sounds like cultural appropriation of bars?
No, that
like,
sounds whack as fuck.
You're taking our drinking culture and you're taking everything except the fucking alcohol.
The funny thing is, if you meet a girl there, she has no excuse.
What?
If you meet a girl there, she has no excuse.
This is what I look like. No, yep.
Well, yeah. Not that. Just like, I didn't mean to go home with them. Like, bitch, you had 7 Dr. Peppers.
Yeah. Beer you goggles did not apply.
Nope. You had 6 shots of maple syrup.
Would you go to a sober curious?
Absolutely
sober
not.
Sober curious. You wouldn't go?
No, fuck no. I feel like why the people not? There would be lame as fuck.
No.
Boring.
It just goes back to the argument of, do you need to have alcohol to have a good time?
No, I don't need to have alcohol to have a good time.
So why wouldn't you go?
But if you're trying to have a good time without stuff that has a good time, you need to have a good time to have a good time. And that's just alcohol. A 50-50 shot, bro.
Of going out and having a good time?
Yeah, dude.
With or without alcohol is what you're saying?
No, it's just, no, it's not that. It's going to a place that acts like something it isn't. I just feel like it would be filled with douchebags.
So what
kind of person would?
So what makes a bar?
What makes a bar?
Alcohol is what you're saying.
Yeah,
What's the difference between a lounge and a bar? How fucking dare you come at me with rationality?
No, what's the difference? What do you mean?
I don't know. I'm just saying. I'm saying there's no difference. That's my point.
There's no difference.
I was trying to think
of a bar is a bar. Like, I think of a bar as a bar. Like, the bar goes across, and then there's a bartender on the other side serving whatever drinks they serve. You can have a sober bar. That's fine.
Okay.
It's just what kind of fuck face would hang out at that bar
I would
all
go.
Night acting like, yeah, once. Go. It would be like an experience. They'd be out of business in 4 months because nobody would actually go hang. No. Happy hour at the bar?
Yeah, I fucking love juice.
Sprites half off?
They might have like juice boxes.
You know bars have juice. You don't have to get alcohol.
I know.
Oh.
I did that once when I gave up alcohol for Lent.
I thought you weren't religious.
This was before I started really thinking about shit.
This was before you gave up Lent for Lent?
Yeah.
I gave up Lent for Lent when I was 12. I never fucking looked back, dude.
I gave up Lent and then I was like, you know what? I'm just going to keep giving it up.
Yeah. I've been doing great, though.
But I remember I went to bars and I would always order like a lemonade or a Coke or something like
that. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, you get those for free if you say you're the DD?
This is true.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got hooked up for a while. But I mean, I would still go.
So where's this non-alcohol bar at?
A good portion of them are in New York, as most.
They're going to go trends. So out of business. You know what rent is in New York?
That's not true. According to CNN, people of all ages are drinking less beer, while millennials are drinking less overall. So a good portion of companies, including startups and the giant alcohol companies, are starting to invest in non-alcoholic beverages and experiences, such as being sober curious.
But look at what you do to your market. You've knocked out half of your market.
You're not knocking out anything. You're developing an untapped market.
No, you aren't, because everybody can get any drink at a bar. If you quit alcohol, you can only serve non-alcohol drinks. So the people who want alcohol have no reason to go to your bar. If you want, my bad. If you want alcohol,
that's that bass drum they're talking about.
I felt like Prince. Purple rain, purple. No, if you want alcohol, you can go to a bar and get alcohol or not.
Okay.
Now, if you open a place that only serves this type of drink, you've limited your market. And a place where rent is $20,000 a month, good fucking luck, bro.
Do
you have to be 21 to get in? Because I want to hang out with a bunch of 7-year-olds.
Probably not. I would still go. Not to hang out with the 7-year-olds, because clearly nobody likes hanging out with someone who's under 21. But I'm just trying to say that if you go to a bar, you're looking, at least for me, I mean, I'm looking for like atmosphere, music,
absolutely.
Good people, good company, good drinks. None of that equation requires alcohol within it. So I'm okay with being sober curious. This actually sounds like a really cool idea, and I'm looking forward to seeing if it expands and continues on. That's pretty fucking cool, I think.
I think it's fucking whack.
Oh, man. You're not super curious at all. Man. Well, I'm going to throw that one fucking into the trash.
What do you want to talk about now?
I want to talk about fucking Instagram star Ari.
Hmm?
Have you heard of Ari?
No, this is like a learning session today.
Is it a ride?
I've been in Puerto Rico for a week, dude.
There's a lot of shit going on. So
I don't give a fuck about
anything.
We got
to go through a lot of stuff. There's a lot of shit going down. This is Instagram star Ari, and she has 2 million followers, and she couldn't sell 36 t-shirts.
And she what?
That was the headline that's been going around.
She couldn't sell 36 shirts?
She could not sell 36 t-shirts.
What's on the t-shirt, though? A dong or something?
Yeah, it's actually like, you know, for those at home, you see the fucking picture right here. But think of it like the Kanye super lazy, real neutral colors, and just maybe just a brand name. I think her clothing line was called Era, and it just says Era on it.
Okay.
Very, very generic shit. You can get this shit at Walmart and whatnot. Point being is that she had 2 million followers, and she needed to sell 36 t-shirts in order to continue the relationship she had had with this t-shirt company to continue manufacturing. And they said, okay, we'll get to start, you know, just sell 36 to cover whatever costs and whatnot, and then we'll continue from there. She couldn't do it. And it's very indicative of the bullshit called influencers. Social media influencers, have you heard of them?
Yeah.
It's fucking bullshit. I think it's horseshit. And I think this is a really good testament to it. I mean, she was launching a clothing line. She only had to sell 36, and she couldn't do it. A lot of people are attesting to it, not only the fact that it was just a shitty product and nobody wanted to buy.
And how much was the shirt?
It was pretty affordable.
Yeah.
It wasn't relative like Kanye pricing, but it was generally affordable within the realm of what you would consider affordability. But she just didn't market it. She didn't push it. So she only had 2 posts within her Instagram that pushed the product out to those 2 million followers. So she had a shitty product, didn't push it, and she couldn't sell. So it just goes to show, it was very fascinating. Like, you can have all these millions and millions of followers, and you have all these companies hitting you up to like, promote our product, we'll give you money. But you have, you know, probably 1 million of those are fucking robots and aren't fucking real anyways.
It's funny how important those people think they are, but like, if they don't post, no one gives a fuck.
Well, that's the thing. And you think you are. So you have 2 million followers, so automatically you have the little blue check and you think you're important and you can post, you know, I'm on vacation or I'm just eating my ice cream cone. And you fucking tag like some company that paid you to eat the ice cream cone. And that company thinks that they're going to see
a return.
And that's not the case at all. Some of these influencers are total bullshit. And there should be like some way of validating how many of those.
How did this story even come to float?
The fact that she couldn't do it.
Oh.
It made news. She posted online that she was selling the shirts, and then she posted online that she failed in the endeavor.
What a stupid bitch.
Yeah. I get the transparency. Totally appreciate that.
She was hoping 36 people cared.
Even I could sell 36, you know, items.
The whole thing sounds fucked up to me because I don't know what kind of manufacturing deal would pivot on 36 items being sold. That sounds fake as fuck.
So you think the story's made up?
No, I don't know what the story. I don't know. I just couldn't care less. But I see your point where the influencers are hollow.
I mean, was it even a thing? Would you want to be a social media influencer?
No, because I would probably influence people negatively.
and that's what we're doing with the show?
Are we influencing people negatively?
I think we're influencing people to think for themselves and really have an opinion on something. Yeah, things that matter.
That's not negative.
I think that's definitely positive.
Yeah, we're doing good things here, dude.
Don't be Steve Johnson.
Is she a child?
She's 18.
Oh, yeah. Fuck her then.
Yeah.
I don't want to be talking shit about a little girl.
Even if she is a little girl.
What?
If she's younger, if she's within that realm of a generation that is striving to capitalize on social media fame.
How the fuck
did
she get 2 million followers at 18?
She's got to be 18.
Showing her titty?
Probably. Again, go fuck yourself. I mean, it goes back to just what makes a social media influencer, what's it mean to be social media famous. It's all of it. It's just fucking fairy dust.
Are there people
like Bitcoin
really out there buying shit when someone posts? Like, is that a real thing? Like, oh, Kim K posted, I got to get it. Like, well, does that exist?
A good example is Kylie Jenner. When she posted that Snapchat was effectively dead, they took a loss in the stock market.
What a bitch.
I mean, that's being an influencer. You can post about your thoughts about a particular subject or item or thing, and have an adverse effect on it. I mean, that's the theory of it, and it's very reflective of, like, the people that can do it, like the Kardashians that are famous for not doing anything. They're famous for being famous.
We should sell 36 random things and tag that girl and everyone.
Oh, down.
You want to do it?
Yeah.
All right, first off. Crystal bottle of water.
Bottle of water. It's a racket.
$1.
We're going to figure it out. We're gonna put our product out, and we're going to sell 36 items of it.
Okay.
And
tag her in each sale.
Each sale. We have a more dedicated following than your 2.6 million.
You got time to make 36 things?
Oh yeah, we'll find out. I'm gonna find out what the price point was.
And we'll make a similar
T-shirt. We're gonna make the exact same product. We're gonna make T-shirts.
This bitch doesn't even know where she's in competition with us.
She's about to.
Yeah.
We're gonna go viral, and we're gonna make the exact same price point T-shirts, and we're gonna sell 36 of them. And yes, we will tag her in every sale.
Okay.
And hopefully, we'll generate some. Furious tweeting.
Oh, I got in a tweet fight with United.
Oh, did you say Ralph Garman?
No, that was last time.
No.
And then I said, the girl said she didn't have a last name. The customer service rep.
She did one of those?
She said, I don't have, I was like, what's your first name? I was like, can I get your name? She's like, Linda. I said, Linda, you got a last name? She's like, I don't have a last name. I was like, how do you cash a check? So then.
Let me see your social security card.
I did like the white thing to do, right? The right thing to do. Send a bunch of emails, right? And then I tweeted them, and then they tweeted back, representatives are not required to give their last name. And I said, oh, no, you didn't read right. I said she says she didn't have a last name.
Yeah.
Insinuating she was born without and existed all these years without a last name.
Yeah.
Don't misrepresent the situation to your followers.
Yeah.
And then I put, besides, you already refunded us, fucko, because the tweet came 3 days after the refund.
Oh, fantastic.
So they're not, they don't talk to each other.
No.
No.
No, no.
Fuck United. Hey, can we make on the title of this episode hashtag fuck United? No, but hashtag fuck and then hashtag United.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
You're so sweet, dude.
Yeah. I can do what I can with.
What were we talking about?
Well, next thing we're talking about is USA Powerlifting. So not too long ago, USA Powerlifting has banned all transgender women from competing as women.
Yes.
So the organization representative stated that transgender male-to-female individuals having gone through male puberty confer an unfair competitive advantage over non-transgender females due to increased bone density and muscle mass from pubertal exposure to testosterone.
That's why there was female-male competitions to begin with. It was never fair.
However, the bone density, if we're talking about bone density, this fuckhead was using as an example. The bone density of black women is, on average, significantly higher than that of white women. In fact, some studies have shown the bone strength of black women to be higher than that of white men.
So we're just going to
have black women in their own powerlifting organization? Because clearly their bone density is much thicker than their adversaries in competition?
No.
I'm just saying that fuck that argument. If you're going to use that, you know, make sure you come correct with your argument. Ultimately, I agree, yes, that there is some inherent advantage being a man versus a woman in a physical competition. Sure. I don't know exactly where the foundation of that science is. This is just what I am guessing, I guess you could say, presuming, just, you know, based on my experience and
life. Always tripped me out that one conversation that we had where you said there was no scientific difference between a male and female body. Because the reason that there are two different types of competition is because male have
more. I said that there's no scientific difference?
Uh-huh. You said.
I don't know. I have to run the tape. I forget what episode it is, but check it out. Run it back. I don't believe I would say that.
Yeah, because you were saying there's no reason men and women shouldn't compete together.
Yeah,
and then I said in combat sports, how many women have to get their ass beat before you change your mind?
I'm saying if they voluntarily. If two competitors voluntarily enter into a competition, fully understanding what their limitations are, what their pros and cons are in said competition, then no, they should be able to.
Not all women competitors know that the person they're competing with is transgender.
I agree. So in this case, if this organization, USA Powerlifting, if they wanted to include transgender women, then that should be known to all competitors within that organization.
But why compete if you know it's already lopsided?
That's what I'm saying. So if there should be a different organization where they said, we're not going to go that route, if you want to compete within that realm, that would be the organization you want to go into. So not to say like there should be an NFL where it's men only, But if you want to include transgender people within the league, and the NFL doesn't want to do that, then let's start another fucking league and compete there. I'm saying that men and women, if they want to compete against each other, they should be able to do so. Even if it is physical combat. If they want to do so. And as far as like, as far as how many does it take for them to get beat? I mean,
no, because the context of the conversation we were having was that men and women are the same. And I was saying that they aren't. And you said that they are. And I said that they aren't. And you say, yes, they are. And I said, you don't say that.
I don't believe.
I promise.
I don't know.
I promise. You said there's no scientific.
What I'm saying now is that I feel that there's no reason why they can't compete if they don't want to compete with each other. If they want to, go right ahead. However, I do believe that there is some inherent difference between a man's body versus a woman's body.
There definitely is.
Physical strength is exhumed more.
Oh, I know the point you made. You said a woman, a man of equal weight would have the same opportunity to win a fight. That men don't have inherent strengths over women.
If men, yeah.
That's not true.
I still agree to that. I still say if you have a man and a woman, if they have all equal physical attributes, whether it be bone density, whatever the fuck.
Like weight and height.
Weight and height. No.
No what?
I'm saying I don't know enough. Again, it goes back to if they want to have a separation between transgender women versus natural born women, there should be some type of science foundation as to why you're going to separate the two. As of right now, it's just kind of like, you used to be a man. Now you're saying you're a woman, but you were born a man. So you were physically
different,
a little bit more different.
Yeah.
Based on what knowledge? What knowledge?
That men have different bodies than women.
Based on what knowledge?
What do you mean based on what knowledge? Science? The knowledge in my brain.
Have you done testing?
Have I done testing?
Have you
on
done
men?
Research?
So I don't, it's kind of like,
I'm saying precisely
well,
here, what,
let me talk. It's kind of like, hold on. It's kind of like a refrigerator. I can't tell you exactly how the refrigerator works, but I know it's fucking cold in there.
Yeah.
Okay? So I can't tell you the exact scientific evidence, just like you couldn't tell me how they're the same.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's fair for you to try to pivot me in a position where I got to explain myself other than the fact that I know men and women have different bodies.
Well, I'm withholding my assessment. I'm withholding the definitive statement that they're different based upon that fact that I don't know. I don't know that they're not different. I don't know that they are different. My guess by life experience is that they are different. I'm guessing.
I feel like you just said three different things right now.
No,
they're not different. They're the same. They are different.
I'm saying that the way that I fuck with my can't find the right word.
I know.
My inherent feeling is that they are different based upon just life.
Well, how
that's
about
just
like
how I seen
the obvious things.
Well, what's obvious?
Again, your genitalia? That's not your body?
No.
That's not physical.
No, again, it goes back to your genitalia does not distinguish.
No, but the body is physically different. You can't say a man and a woman have the same body. There's obvious.
Well, yes, if you're going to go down in the genitalia route, sure.
But no, physical. We're just talking about body. Physical body. Well, do they have the same body?
No. Like
exactly.
Me and you don't have the same body. That's true, right? You, me, and I don't have the same body. We're both men.
We both
have the same genitalia. I'm trying to split hairs because I feel the argument warrants such. Because we're not enough understanding is known on the subject of being able to define what gender roles are and how that plays into sport and competition. And because I don't know enough on the subject, I can't say definitively what's right and what's wrong when it comes to sport and competition. I will say, just upon my base life experience, I will say that it looks like men are stronger than women inherently, just naturally. However, if you want to go into a sporting event and you want to start splitting hairs about, oh, well, this person was born a man, but now they identify as being a woman, and they're taking, you know, whatever supplements to adjust any, you know, internal chemicals, I don't fucking know. But I'm just saying that I don't know enough.
Well, this came up because a transgender woman went and took all the records.
Correct.
So, I mean, for them to do it on the first shot, it would be pretty evident that there's differences.
Right. I'm saying, I agree. It's very evident that there is, it appears that there is an inherent advantage in being a naturally born man And if you want to compete as a transgender woman within women competition,
that would be unfair.
It seems so. Yes. However, what I'm trying to say is it requires further understanding and further research to really definitively say what
about the two. But you know, there are people that have done that further research. They're just not at this table right now.
I've not seen any.
Oh.
But once we continue that conversation, because I'm sure, again, as it continues to evolve, transgender involvement in gender-specific forums, once they start to blur that line, it certainly becomes a bigger conversation. And I feel like in splitting those hairs, it warrants so. So I'm looking forward to see what the fuck happens with that. But until then, I wouldn't involve them. I think for the sake of the sport and as not knowing enough what we need to know, it would seem like an unfair advantage. Absolutely. USA powerlifting. Nice.
I agree. I always thought it was unfair for a transgender woman to get into women's sports.
Yeah.
I know that there's an NBA and a WNBA for a reason. Because they don't compete at the same level.
That's what it seems so. And then last topic we got for the week. People are fleeing the U.S. to keep from paying off their student loans.
Are they?
That seems kind of fucking smart.
Yeah.
The United States can't garnish your wages if you're working abroad. So they can't take that money out. So if I get a student loan to become a doctor, I'll be a doctor, just not in the United States.
That whole system's fucked up, man.
Yeah. You think that's a smart thing to do? Stupid thing to do?
You know what? Like, I'm not committed to staying on the piece of dirt you were born on.
Okay.
And so if you can do what you want to do somewhere else, like, you should.
Yeah. Like on a bar in Puerto Rico?
I want to do that, dude.
Yeah. I'm down.
I just want to leave.
I just want to get the fuck off this rock. Not,
but that doesn't address the situation with student loans, dude.
Yeah.
The state system and everything with education is fucked, dude.
Yeah, I definitely will agree to that. I mean, if you do leave the country to get away from your student loans, that's a great idea. If you plan on never coming back. If you plan on coming back, then those loans are going to be waiting for you with accrued interest.
What if you go? Oh, do they accrue interest?
Oh, yeah. So it's very millennial of you to kick the fucking can down. Not even millennial, but very American of you to kick the can down the road and just more like, I'll deal with that later.
And student loans, bite you in the ass later. Don't get washed in bankruptcy, huh?
Nope. You cannot claim student loans in bankruptcy. That shit is stuck with you.
What you got to do is get a fake identity, go to school, run it up on that.
Ah.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like Linda from United.
Yeah. No, she didn't have a fake identity. She didn't have it. She only had ident. She had no itty.
But I mean, that's not a bad
what
idea.
What a bitch, right?
Linda from United?
Yeah. Right away, I was like, how do you cash a check? The girl next to her was like, mm-hmm.
Oh. It's true. I mean, I've been in that customer service situation, and it's like, I'm not going to tell you my name.
Yeah, you just say,
yeah.
I'm not going
to
tell you my name.
I don't have to tell you that. What's your last name?
You realize you're so comfortable sucking at customer service that you just lied about having a name to me. You do your job so bad.
That's how much.
So, and then we finally got home Thursday, right?
Yeah.
We had to do a job in Valencia on Friday.
Nice.
And I told Nat, it was 3 hours to get home.
Nice. Did you stop at Six Flags?
No. I was like, hey, you know, if we go the back way, we just go to Vegas.
Oh.
So then we just took off to Vegas and came home yesterday morning. We weren't ready to quit, man.
Living the dream.
Now here we are back at work.
Well, you regret it?
No, hell no.
Nah.
No regrets, bro.
No regrets. That's the way it should be. But until then, let's get deep.
That shit get deep. 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 Man, I swear to God, that shit just gets so deep. 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 Deep.
That shit get deep. Yeah, so let's get deep. I need to know, is it always better to have more choices?
No.
Why is that?
So
I feel with like a lot of more choices, you would have more options.
Yeah, but that's not always.
You can never have too many options, right?
I guess it depends on the perspective, right? So for me, when I'm designing things for clients,
yeah,
they all, like, oh, can I get a couple versions? I'm like, yeah, I'll do my best, and then I'll do ones I don't like as much and present those options to you, right? What do you want me to do, three mediocre ones? I'm going to give you my best option.
Yeah.
So I always try to just give people two options.
Could you just say like, hey, this is my favorite option. I really like this one. But because you said you wanted more options.
I did. I tried not as hard on these other ones. No, you can't tell them that.
No.
It's rude as fuck, I think.
Oh.
But
I would appreciate the honesty.
I think keep it simple.
Right.
Like in most aspects. My son got hurt. We go to the doctor. He's like, all right, you got options. We could put a needle in his head to numb his head. That's going to hurt him. But then we could take our time doing stitches. That won't hurt him. But then he's got to come back and get the stitches out. That will hurt him. And I'm like, all right. And he's like, or you just hold him down. I staple him. It's going to hurt him for 3 seconds, but then we're done. And I was like, well, I'm not the fucking doctor, bro. I was like, what would you do? He's like, staple him. I'm like, then
fuck is
go. Like, what the fuck? But yeah, I don't believe in options too. Like a menu. Yeah, I want a couple options.
See, that was going to be my next example is a menu. I don't want a lot of options. Have you been to like those
the fine restaurants?
No. Okay, but the fine restaurants is what I'm talking about. But I mean, like, you go to, I don't know, like fucking BJ's or the Cheesecake Factory, and they have like a library stack of books of everything on their menu. And you spend the first hour of your visit just going through it. And you're like, so are you guys ready? Like, no, I'm only on like page 4. Like, hold on. I still got to keep going. And what's on page 7?
What about those like Jim's Burgers when they serve like everything from euros to enchiladas?
I have a, what is it? I live in Covina. So there's the Covina fucking.
Tasty.
Covina Tasty.
I hate that place.
No. Fuck, Covina Tasty.
That's the gross one.
That the ice cream spot that I'm thinking about? Yeah, okay, yeah. They have like a million different things.
Yeah.
It's like, you serve ice cream.
And there's only one lady working there.
Yeah, yeah. And they sell like vegan hamburgers. They sell like Chinese food, breakfast burritos.
I bought chili fries there. And she's like, the only chili we have is vegan. Tell me why it tastes like dirt.
You did it wrong.
This tastes just like dirt.
I feel like having a lot of options is not always good. And a good example of just doing one thing right is In-N-Out Burger.
Yeah.
So you go to In-N-Out Burger and their menu just fucking says cheeseburger, hamburger,
double
fries. Yeah. Or the double. That's the one thing they got crazy with.
And you notice if you order a combo, it's the same price as those things added. There's no combo discount like at McDonald's and shit.
Yeah, it's the same exact shit. But you do, you know, just a few things, but you do them extremely well, you're set.
Yeah.
You're good. You don't have to have a lot of options.
Where's a place where you want a lot of options?
Where I want a lot of options?
Oh, I know. A non-alcoholic bar.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, yeah. like
or transgender sports.
Not a lot of options.
No, you want a lot of options. I don't know if I want to put up. No,
that works. That's funny. That's true.
Right?
That agrees with my point. Yeah, that's true.
Where's somewhere where you don't want options?
Where you don't want options? A doctor's office.
Like, you don't want options there?
I want to do the right medical thing. What's the best medical practice? Do that, like you said.
That'd yeah, doctors shouldn't be asking your opinion.
So what do you want to do? Like, or, I don't fucking know. That's why I'm paying
you. What about whenever a pharmacy commercial comes up, or a pharmaceutical, not pharmacy, comes up and they're like, ask your doctor about what? I'm like, if I ask him and he's just a drug dealer.
Yeah.
If he didn't prescribe it to me.
Yeah.
Fucking Chantix.
Yeah, I saw Chantix on the TV screen and they said I should ask you. Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. You want that? Yeah, I'll give you that. Okay.
So
it's not always great to have more options. If you just have, you know.
You know where we need more options?
Have what you
fucking
do.
Airlines.
Well, you do get more options. That's when you get like Frontier and Spirit.
Or what about cable and internet? We need more fucking cable and internet choices.
No, that's true. So
right?
I used to do a door-to-door salesman for fucking AT&T. They used to do like some subcontract bullshit.
Some of our friends were just talking about that too.
Oh, that they used to do door-to-door
salesman? Yeah, for AT&T.
Oh, yeah, some bullshit. Anyways. But yeah, we would go to specific neighborhoods because
AT&T
had that market and no other competitor could go into that market to compete.
And as taxpayers, we laid the lines that they used to transmit that information.
That's fucking horseshit.
This right?
Should just be an open. Whatever happened to free market capitalism? Or car dealerships?
You want more car or less?
Shout out Carvana. I just want to go to a big ass car vending machine, put in a quarter and say, I want.
I'll go to any car dealership that'll sell me a car for a quarter.
Yeah.
But that is kind of neat. They're building one over by my shop.
Yeah, I saw that. Shot the freeway, right?
That's crazy.
Off the 10.
But if someone throws one rock.
Cars for everybody.
Just the bottom row or just the top row, actually.
They come straight down. I don't know.
So.
But yeah, car dealerships. I mean, you go to like the Toyota dealership, you can only get Toyota financing, Toyota deal, Toyota package, blah, blah, blah. But if you put like, you know, fucking cars in like Stater Brothers, then you're going to be able to have some options.
Are you high?
I'm just saying. That would work, right?
Cars at Stater Brothers?
Yeah.
The last thing I want is some bad boy trying to tell me about a transmission.
Or Walmart.
Oh, we don't even
Walmart buy. Walmart Supercenter, right?
They're already fucked for their Wrangler jeans deal.
I don't shop at Walmart. But I'm just saying, if you wanted to go like a Supercenter,
I go to Walmart
Costco.
One night a year, and I'm not going to talk about it because it'll get edited. Now, options, man, I don't know. And then also it depends on you. Like, if you've if you're given options, are you a decision maker? Are you somebody who goes, I fucking hate people that can't choose.
I don't understand that. That's understandable if you are like, if you are at the Cheesecake Factory, you have no fucking idea what you want to get because there's 20 pages of options. But if you go to In-N-Out Burger, there's no reason why you got to stand there and look at the menu.
Well, you're not prepared.
You know what's on the menu. You go to In-N-Out, you're like,
my kids, every drive through, what do you want to drink? What do they got? You always order the same thing anyways.
You know you want a high C orange.
Fuck!
Just order it.
They got soda. Which color do you want?
That's true.
Right?
I order by color. Yeah. At what age do you stop ordering by color?
I still say purple and orange. And
okay. Now I think about it, I still do too. When I order like snow cones.
Yeah.
I want the blue one.
Oh, what about? Oh, I know too many choices. The snow cone places that have 1,000 flavors.
1,000 places?
1,000 flavors
for snow cones?
Well, actually, okay, I guess that's more of a southern thing. In Arkansas, they got snow cone shacks that pop up over the summer. But they got like 500 fucking flavors.
Really?
And if you say red, it only narrows it down to 20.
Their head explodes.
There's 20 fucking flavors.
Like variations of red? Like salmon?
Yeah, there's pink? No, there's like watermelon, sour watermelon, watermelon rime, cherry, black cherry. Black cherry is still red. I don't know why.
Hey, that's dope.
Got me worked up, dude.
Now fucking on ice cream cones?
I don't like choices, dude.
Snow cones? Yeah, okay. All right, fine. We won't think about that instead. Let's talk about unwritten laws that should be or should not be. This is to be or not to be an unwritten law.
To be or not to be. That is the question.
Damn right. That is definitely the question. And it is an unwritten law. And what unwritten law that I want to explore today that I feel is an automatic to be. Do not stop in the middle of a busy sidewalk. If you're walking somewhere, you have a trajectory, you're on a path, continue. And if you are not going to continue, step to the fucking side.
Yeah, if you don't know where you're going, just ease your way into the middle of the street. Please.
Just in the middle of the street. Just keep walking.
We just came, like I said, from Vegas. And that people just fucking stop.
Yeah.
Everyone's walking and they just stop.
Yeah, I feel like that should be a determination. If you have to understand that if you are walking in a pathway and all of a sudden you're checking your phone and all of a sudden you get that one text you're waiting for and you just stop. Or people that are like the tourists that they're walking and they just stop because they want to take a quick photo. But they just stop. Or fucking at Disneyland. People are like, they pull out the map and they just stop right in the middle of fucking Main Street.
See, think about that whenever you think about like flying cars. How come we don't have flying cars? Because motherfuckers like that. They just stop.
Motherfuckers, they just start hovering in the air.
Motherfuckers run out of gas on the floor.
I just don't
understand. And they want flying cars.
I mean, I get being distracted, but the amount of like awareness for other people, you have zero fucks, zero care for others. That you're going to stop. Even I go to the supermarket. I go to the supermarket and I'm pushing my cart down the aisle, Stater Brothers. And
looking for a new Lexus.
Looking for a new Lexus. And I'm like, hey, I'm going to browse these Hondas real quick.
Yeah.
I'm going to pull off to the fucking side and move my shopping cart to the side in front of like the store brand pasta sauce that no one's going to fucking touch.
Hey, fuck you, dude.
I'm just saying that I'm going to put my shopping cart in front of there because no one's going to look at it. And no one's going to fucking... Because
you're conscientious of moving
yeah,
around.
Yeah, yeah. I'm
how do you react when someone parks it right in front of you?
Whoa. I'm like, oh, I didn't know where's the red light at? Where's the stop sign? I could be super fucking petty.
Sometimes
man.
I get like right behind their ear. I'm like, oh my God, you just stopped so quick. Oh my God, we're going. Oh, I almost touched you.
Oh, so close. Oh,
can you just grab them? And
that's what I want to do. Like, imagine, like, you're just walking down the street, and someone just...
That's how you walk.
This is how I walk. Yeah. I'm walking down the street.
You're going to be at that straight parade, dude. Yeah. Oh, we're straight. The straight parade. Fuck. God, you're terrible at acting today, dude. Fuck, man. You have auditions tomorrow?
This is why we have a podcast. We don't have visuals, because I don't fucking think about these things. So as I was walking down the street...
You're going to have the weirdest kid if you act out the stories when you read them.
Milo's going to be fun. So I'm walking down the street, and if someone stops in front of me, I'm like, just fucking move.
Yeah, just go.
Yeah.
You, I can't see you. Like that, dude.
Yeah.
I fucking hate when people aren't aware of the world around them, dude.
It's just so insensitive to others. Like,
yeah.
It's stupid. Bitches, right? That's what I'm trying to say. So that's my to be or not to be. So we're about to close the show. Before we do, we want to visit the soapbox with Motion. Anything you want to
say? I don't know if I do have anything.
You don't have anything?
You know what, dude? I just don't have any rants because I had a beautiful week and a half, dude.
That's true. That's true.
Before Puerto Rico, we took the kids to Vegas for a week.
You know, that's why you weren't as combative.
I wasn't, dude.
I feel like you're just like,
I just came back from an island, bro.
You know what?
You know the thing about an island is you got to be nice because you're going to run into that motherfucker again because you're on an island.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
That makes sense.
I have these theories about Los Angeles and why people suck so bad. It's because you're never going to see that motherfucker again. People are shitting on the freeway because we got too many lanes. People in the South are nice on the road because you only have two or three lanes.
That's why Linda didn't give you her last name.
Linda's cunt. I figured out her last name. It's cunt.
She was never going to see you again. She was like, I don't have a last name.
Yeah, joke's on her. We spent the night in Houston. I saw that bitch again in the morning.
Did you call her Linda?
No, I was like, listen, Linda. Listen, Linda. Like that little boy.
Oh, did you do that during the argument?
I did do that. I put that in the Twitter. I put that hashtag, listen, Linda. So, you know what I noticed the other day? You know syrup jars?
Yeah.
They got the new pourers?
Yeah, like the...
Yeah, like so you don't spill and shit?
Like the little thing, the pop-tops?
So, yeah. Like, how the fuck are syrup pourers getting better and cell phone chargers getting worse?
Planned obsolescence.
I don't know what that is, I fucking believe you.
Planned obsolescence. It's in... why do cars today suck more...
Oh. Because you want it to be replaced. Is that what you're saying? It's marketing?
Yes.
I got you.
They give you shitty car parts because they know it's going to fucking break and they want you to buy more. I was watching comedians in cars getting coffee.
Uh-huh.
And Seinfeld tore up this fucking Cadillac. He fucking hated it. But a good point they made was like, here are these like side, like automatic fucking door locks and whatnot. But inside the door is an emergency release. Why'd they put the emergency release in there if it's fucking technologically advanced? Because they know it's going to break. It's fucking true. Planned obsolescence. Look it up. What else?
No, they're all bad. I shouldn't even write these things down.
I hate you. I hate you. Hashtag fuck Linda. Okay, cool. Fantastic. As always, we want to thank you all for joining us here in Poundtown. But before we go, we want to remind you to subscribe and leave us a 5-star review on iTunes or wherever you're listening to help the show grow. Visit our website, socialnuisance.com, for all the latest episodes and find our social media links to Facebook and Instagram. And not to mention, sign up for our email list to keep in touch. Lastly, don't forget there's power in numbers, and together we can be a nuisance towards the betterment of humanity. Invite your friends to Poundtown and help the show grow. As always, my name's Imagine Motion.
Yes, sir.
We'll see you fuckers next week, right?
Let's throw a summer nuisance party, dude.
Oh, that's great.
You down?
But first, it's got to be like not as fucking hot.
Yeah. Let's throw a summer party in the fall.
I'm down.
Right? Hawaiian shirts only?
Oh.
No underwear allowed.
That's the only way to party. We'll see you guys next time.